With us now is Cecile Richards. She's the president of Planned Parenthood Action Fund, a Hillary Clinton supporter, and the daughter of Ann Richards, the late, great, former governor of Texas, the reddest of red states, where a stunning new poll of the University of Houston has Hillary Clinton within the margin of error. She is trailing Trump by only 3 points in that survey, 41% to 38%. Cecile, welcome. Tell us, we're going to get to some news in a moment, but just since I read the thing about Texas already, can Hillary Clinton win Texas?
It's obviously within the margin, and it's pretty interesting. I've been thinking about mom's race a lot. You know, she ran against a guy who was a millionaire, who turned out had never paid taxes, who made jokes about sexual assault, and she never had a poll showing her winning, and she beat him. And I think there is a kind of an energy and enthusiasm among Clinton supporters in Texas that is completely absent among the Republican Party in Texas, so it could happen.
Clayton Williams is the man you're referring to,
yes.
Right? Okay, just for the record.
Yes, for history's sake, for those who don't remember. But and Ann Richards was elected against all odds in that state, and again, so I think it could certainly happen.
Democrats haven't won a statewide race in Texas in a good long while.
I think
that's right. If she won, what would it mean for the politics of Texas and for Hillary? If Hillary Clinton won Texas, she'd win the White House. What would it mean for a Clinton presidency if she could win Texas?
Well, I think, look, the great thing about Hillary Clinton is she is someone who knows how to work across the aisle and to bring people together to solve problems. And I think people are desperately looking for that, not only in this election, but they're looking for that in the next president. And I think Texas is a state that is trending more moderate. You know, obviously there's a huge growth in different populations there. So it would be a good sign and, frankly, would breathe a lot of energy into the Democrats in Texas who've been looking for a victory for many, many years, as you say.
So about an hour and 45 minutes from now, we learn there's going to be a press conference nearby here being held by Danny Williams, who is the gentleman who claims to be son of Bill Clinton, claims to be the abandoned son of Bill Clinton. And he's going to be at this press conference demanding a DNA sample from President Clinton to prove the paternity. This is obviously another Trump-related stunt. We had one at the last debate. We're now seeing it here at this debate. What's your comment on that? On what this has become, on these kinds of incidents, and this one in particular?
I mean, I think this whole campaign by Donald Trump has been one of negativity, and it's really discouraging to see when there's so many issues that the American people care about, job creation, health care, a lot of issues, that instead of talking about those in the debates, that he continues to go into the gutter. I think this debate tonight, many people, given how Hillary Clinton is doing, given the move of women and young people and moderate voters to her, I think a lot of people will be looking at this debate and seeing her as the future president. And I hope that we will have a conversation about issues and not just about these sort of, you know, really tactics that are not related to what this election's about.
Is it your view entirely that Bill Clinton's, that this has been a big part of the campaign now for the last couple of weeks, is it your view that Bill Clinton's past and the alleged sexual abuse that he perpetrated on women, alleged, right, that has no place in the campaign, totally irrelevant, not, should be completely out of bounds?
I think people know everything about Bill Clinton. I mean, he was president a long time ago. The important thing is Hillary Clinton is running for president, and people are evaluating her on what she wants to do for the American people. I think she has clearly laid out her plans. I would say Donald Trump has been very incapable. I mean, he's run a campaign where you can't tell what he wants to do or what his policies are. He's frankly just run a campaign of negativity and personal attacks, going after women, going after immigrants, going after Muslims, going after disabled people. I think the American people want something more, and I believe Hillary Clinton has showed that she goes high when he goes low. And again, I certainly hope that's what we see tonight, is that Donald Trump finally talking about plans and issues and not about personal attacks.
He proposed this week limits on people leaving the executive branch and going to lobby for corporate interests. Is that a good idea?
You know, I don't know the exact particulars
just the concept
of that.
Of trying to put more limits on the ability of people to go through the revolving door, be in government, and then go lobby.
Look, I think there's a lot of things we need to change. I think Citizens United is number one. I mean, I think obviously we have seen money in politics has been a corrupting influence, and there probably are other things we should consider. I got to be honest, though, I think one of the things that's important to me in this debate is there are some real differences between Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton that haven't been covered in the debates. Obviously, I care passionately about women's health care. You know, we at Planned Parenthood serve 2.5 million people every single year for health care. Donald Trump says he wants to end that. He said he wants to end, you know, overturn Roe versus Wade by appointing justice to the Supreme Court that would do that. These are issues that actually affect people. You know, he's against equal pay for women. He's against the minimum wage. I think Hillary Clinton has put forward specific proposals about how she would improve the lives of women, of families, and that's really where the American people want to focus. Again, I hope tonight, I'll be excited to be in the audience, I hope that's what we get to tonight.